Hello everybody, welcome back. The Mercury Star Runner is a medium-sized courier vessel with an asymmetrical design that can carry your cargo or data with safety across the universe. The Mercury is focusing mostly on cargo and data running, but has the potential to operate as a smuggling vessel as well. Introducing like this a multi-crew, multi-role vessel that can carry pretty much anything, eliminating the need to have different ships for different types of delivery jobs. With a length at around 40 meters and a maximum crew of 3, the Mercury is indeed a bigger vessel than other dedicated runners, but not that big to prefer something smaller. With a quick look at its capabilities, we can see that because of this new ship, other vessels like the Herald, the Freelancer, or even the Cutlass Black are not necessary anymore to be a successful courier of any kind. The ability to combine and perform 3 different jobs with one vessel is viable and something all of us are after. When discussing cargo capacity, things are very clear to me. Thanks to its spacious cargo hold that can carry up to 96 SEU, the Mercury will be my go-to ship for cargo running the moment it joins the persistent universe. Something that means my Cutlass Black and Freelancer will not see much action after this point. It is only logical if you think about it. With 30 more SEU than the Freelancer and double the cargo capacity of the Cutlass, I don't see any reason to pick those vessels over the Mercury. Additionally, the Mercury has space to hide contraband thanks to the easy access to the ventilation system, giving you the ability to also perform smuggling successfully. What interests me the most though is how the Mercury compares to the Herald, since they are both described as medium data vessels. They can both store and intercept data. The Herald comes with an advanced encryption software, an armored computer core that runs on a dedicated server, and EMP protection. With its array, it can transmit and intercept data that can store on its exterior data storage pods that can be later detached to create a drop point. The Mercury, on the other hand, has a built-in encryption protocol with a programmable kill switch and customizable security configurations, can intercept data with its scanners, and more importantly, keep them secure in the interior, something that is giving to the Mercury an edge when comparing the two. In terms of firepower and actual protection, the Mercury comes with 2 size 3 mounts, 2 turrets with 2 size 2 weapons each on top and bottom below that offer protection from every direction, and 2 missile pylons with 2 size 1 missiles each. The Herald, on the other hand, has 1 size 3 and 2 size 2 mounts, as well as 8 size 1 missiles to protect its data. The Herald is indeed faster thanks to its huge engine, but its defenses lack, since it comes with 2 small shields, while the Mercury has 2 medium. The Mercury's interior offers a dedicated scanner station, data storage room, a recreation room, and the crew quarters for 3 persons, along, of course, its spacious cargo hold, while the Herald is basically one room divided in the cockpit, the scanners area, and the tiny crew quarters, with a cargo capacity of 0 SCU, which means that you cannot really use the Herald for anything else than data running. It is clear to me that the capacity of the Mercury to perform 3 different jobs at the same time efficiently makes it the king of courier jobs, and I personally don't see a reason to continue using other similar vessels. No matter how much I like its design and capabilities, the Mercury is introducing a serious problem of power creep in Star Citizen by outperforming other similar vessels and in reality turning them obsolete. Either way, this is the Mercury Star Runner, a super courier in the verse that is going to be your number one vessel if you like doing delivery jobs. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. I am SquidofLove and I will see you around the verse. Bye bye.